So I work on the evolution of animal social behavior and species interactions, and mostly positive interactions between species, such as mutualisms. And in my work, I try to model the dynamics of how the interaction proceeds, either in a social interaction or an interaction between two species, and then get these dynamics of the interaction integrated with the evolutionary dynamics that happen over generations, and see how the evolution shapes these interactions. So, for example, some of my work is done on the symbiosis between legume plants like soybeans and a type of bacteria in the soil called rhizobia. And in this interaction, the rhizobia are taken up by the plant roots, and then they form these plant organs called nodules, and they fix atmospheric nitrogen in the air into a form that the plants can use, which basically they fertilize the plant, and then they get carbohydrates from the plant in return. So this is a mutually beneficial interaction for both the rhizobia and the legumes. But the question is how much benefit each party gets from this interaction. So one of the things that I'm trying to model is I'm trying to model this interaction as a negotiation, biochemical negotiation between the rhizobia and the plant, and then see how this negotiation outcome affects the evolutionary trajectories of the rhizobia. So from a basic research perspective, this is interesting because a lot of interesting questions appear when evolution when selection acting on one individual depends on its interaction with different individuals. So then that opens up room for a lot of interesting dynamics and a lot of different evolutionary outcomes. And we still don't know exactly how things work out as a function of these interactions. And from a more practical perspective, the social behavior research is interesting. It's important because most animals are social. They depend on their social environment. They depend on their social interactions to survive and to breed. So and a lot of the actually endangered animals are highly social, and so like cheetahs, for example. So understanding the social behavior, how the social behavior of animals evolve and how it functions, actually can get us some indication of how to conserve these animals and how to prevent them from going extinct. In the mutualism side of things, for example, this interaction that I talked about between legumes and rhizobia is tremendously important because it's supplying it's one of the most important nitrogen inputs to the ecosystems around the world. So basically, soybeans and peas and a lot of legumes are important food crops for humans. And their interaction with rhizobia allow them to grow. So this is very important for food production, and it's also very important for ecosystem functioning because of these nitrogen inputs to the ecosystem allow them to function and thrive. So if we could figure out how to best use these rhizobia in an agricultural system, that would reduce the need for commercial fertilizer, for artificial sort of fertilizers, which cause all kinds of ecological problems. So this research has a lot of different applications in different areas.